टुडे वी आर डूइंग क्लास सिक्स चैप्टर 14 कंस्ट्रक्शन एक्सरसाइज 14.1 फुल।
टुडे वी आर डूइंग एक्सरसाइज 14.A। दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। ड्रॉ अ सर्कल ऑफ रेडियस 3 सेंटीमीटर 3.2 सेंटीमीटर। लेट्स ड्रॉ इट।
दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। हेयर यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू ड्रॉ अ सर्कल ऑफ रेडियस 3.2। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन कंपास यू विल टेक 3.2 रेडियाई। सो हेयर आई हैव टेकन 3.2 सेंटीमीटर। देन आफ्टर टेकिंग 3.2 सेंटीमीटर इन योर कंपास यू विल मार्क अ सेंटर फर्स्ट ऑन द पेपर and then you will put the needle of the compass on the center and after taking 3.2 centimeter radius you are required to draw the circle. This is 3.2 centimeter. Now you are required to draw a radius from center to the point of a circle. This line is called radius. Now you will write the length of the line. This will be 3.2 centimeter and you will name O.
This is question number 2. With the same center O, draw two circles of radii 4 centimeter and 2.5 centimeter. Now let's draw this.
Now this is question number 2. With the same center O, draw two circles of radii 4 centimeter and 2.5 centimeter. So first of all you are required to take 4 centimeter in your compass after marking a center. Now I have taken here 4 centimeter. Now with the center draw a circle. That circle is of 4 centimeter. Now after that you are required to take 2.5 centimeter radius in your compass. Now I am taking 2.5 centimeter in the compass and after taking 2.5 centimeter in the compass the needle of the compass will be put on the center and then a circle of 2.5 centimeter. This is the circle of radius 2.5 centimeter I have drawn. Now here you can see with the same center I have drawn two circles. Now we will draw the radius here from the center. Now this radius is of the interior. This is 2.5 centimeter radius here, 2.5 centimeter. This is interior. Now the second radius of the outer circle I am drawing from the center to the point of a circle. Now this is 4 centimeter. Now I will write here 4 centimeter. The length of this radius is 4 centimeter and I have marked O. Now this is question number 3. Draw a circle and any two of its diameter. If you join the ends of these diameters, what is the figure obtained? So here, first of all, we will draw a circle, then two diameters, then we will join the ends of these diameters and then we are required to write which figure is obtained. Ki kaun si figure jo hai wo diameters ke end points ko join hone ke baad aa rahi hai. And then second figure you are also required to draw where diameters are perpendicular to each other. Means jab diameters perpendicular ho to kaun si figure aayegi aur perpendicular nahi hai to kaun si figure aayegi. Then this we are required to check and then now let's draw this. Now this is question number 3. In this you are required to draw a circle and then you are required to draw two diameters and then join these diameters. Now first of all we will draw a circle that I have drawn here of any radius you can take and then you will draw one by one.
this is first diameter of the circle, and then you will draw second diameter of the circle. Now here this is the second diameter of the circle. Now after drawing, now here you can see one circle and two diameters I have drawn. Now you are required to join these ends one by one. You are required to join these ends. Now I have joined these ends. Now which figure is there? You can see A, B, C, D. Now these letters are there, A, B, C, D. Now this figure is a rectangle. So here you can see the figure obtained is a rectangle. Now this is second part I am drawing. You are required to draw a circle of any radius again, and then you will draw first diameter. Now this is first diameter I have drawn, and then the second diameter that you will draw, this will be perpendicular to the first diameter. For drawing this, you are required to mark one arc, then second arc in this way, then you will mark other arc, and then from that part you are going to mark other arc. Now in this way you are required to draw. Now you will join this this center of circle to the arc, to the intersecting point of arcs. Now this diameter will be perpendicular to the other diameter. Now here you can see, according to the question, we have drawn this. Now you will join these arcs, join these A, B, C, D points. Now which figure we are going to obtain? This is the question. Now first of all we will join. Now here you can see the figure obtained, this is a rectangle. Now here the first figure is a rectangle and the second figure is a square, because all the sides of this are equal. This is question number 4. Draw any circle and mark ABC such that. So here any circle we can draw, any radius we are required to take. But ABC point should be, A point is on the circle, B is in the interior of the circle, and C is in the exterior of the circle. Now let's draw this. Now this is question number 4. Draw a circle and mark point A, B, C such that. So first of all you will draw a circle with any radius you can take, because it is not mentioned. So I have drawn a circle. Now you are required to put A on the circle. Now this is, you can see point A I have marked on the circle, then point B is in the interior of the circle. Now you can see this is point B in the interior, means circle ke andar banana hai point B. And then C, this is O, this is center of the circle that I have marked. Now C is in the center of the circle. Now I have made C exterior. Now here you can see C is out of the circle. Now this is question number 5. Let A be as the center of two circles of equal radii. यहाँ पे हमें दो circles बनाने हैं जिनकी radius equal होनी चाहिए और उनके centers A and B हो. And after that we will intersect these circles and then name the intersection point as C and D, and then we will join the line C, D, and then after we are required to check, are this is AB perpendicular to CD or not, means are at right angle or not. Now let's draw this. This is question number 5. Here you are required to draw first circle, and with the same radius you are required to draw another circle. तो पहले तो हमने एक सर्कल बनाया और उसके बाद सेकेंड सर्कल भी हमने सर्कल को ही एक पॉइंट मान के बनाया है. Now here you can see both the circles are of equal radius. Now we will join the centers of both the circles. Now you can see we have joined the centers of the both circles. Now this is the line. Now we will mark these centers A and B. Now the points that are intersecting, now we will join these points one by one. Now another line you are required to draw. This is C and D. Another point is D. Now this is question. Check whether AB and CD are at right angles or not. So this only we can check by protractor. We will measure the angles. AB and CD, are they at right angles or not? Now let measure this AB and CD. Now here you can see I am measuring that it is exact 90 degree, you can see. So this is to be examined that AB and CD are at right angles. So here you can see the point is at 90 degree. Now this question has completed.